Well, Alex Lees gets away, but not in overly convincing fashion. It's a funny kind of place. Because of that, the ball can just run away. It's such a fast outfield here. Ooh. You always felt it was coming. You always feel it's coming with Zach Crawley. Just cannot help himself to go for the drive. Gets it away. He was looking to drive that in front of square. Again, it was Southey's scramble seam ball, and that's why it went behind square. There is that drive ball. Crawley goes for it, hits it well. Yeah! He's gone! Gone! That is fantastic piece of fielding, and for Tremble to get back to the stumps and remove the bales, fantastic work from New Zealand.
Kane Williamson had two opportunities for runouts in the first innings, missed both of them. That's brilliant there. Balance, Bolt, even better. That is outstanding.
Just a bit of relief. He's been tested very much on the front foot, pushing forward. Maybe just make him feel a whole lot better. Well, he had a go at one of those a couple of overs ago, and he missed it this time. It looks to me like batting is hard work for him at the moment, and he's just going to throw the hands at him, try and get himself up and running. Lovely shot. Now, that might just settle him down. It wasn't quite a full half volley, but he's just beginning to find the middle of the bat. Finds the gap again. It will go quickly to the boundary. So just a few boundaries in the over, and that will just settle him down. He's up to 20 from 27, 35 for one. Lovely shot, super shot. Tim Southey's going at the pads, and Ollie Pope saying, that's where I want it. I'm going to pump it back down the ground. Finds the gap again. Wonderful shot. He's not holding back today, Zach Crawley. He's going to take the spin on. 47 for one. Lovely shot. He just leans on it. Beautiful timing. For no one else. And that is why he's there. And he's fallen into the trap. That is a brilliant bit of bowling. It's also a brilliant bit of captaincy, because he's enticed Crawley to play on the offside. The captain was lurking. Brilliant.
The man had been moved to say, go on, take me on in the offside. It's not there to drive. It's really not there to drive. And Kane Williamson, who had a big role to play in the first dismissal.
That different. When you see the replay, you'll see the length and the fact that he smothers the ball. That's fair enough. And the shoulder gets into the ball. And that's a wonderful shot.
A little bit of room and lovely. The hind point on the offside.
Short, nicked.
Oh, it's gone through. We saw a couple of those in the New Zealand batting innings that went between Billings and Root. The crease line, the white line. Oh. That's certainly not the case, so lovely. Good use of the feet and timing. Williamson will not catch up with that. Boundary to finish the over. 14 runs from it, 74 for two.
Oh, that's good. No figure of speech is needed for that from Joe Root through mid-wicket. That's beautiful. 79 for two.
That's not going to work, because that is too easy for Joe Root. Oh, that is a very good delivery. That runs? It is runs as well. It's flowing away off the bat.
Down,
one's gone underground a bit, but beautifully watched and controlled from Pope. Oh, here we go. Sick of that wide outside the line of off stump. I'll just help myself to half a dozen with a ludicrous.
In the air, but safe. Pass backward point for four.
not where he intended it to go. Ollie Pope.
Inside edge, and that could be his 50. He's played some lovely drives, he won't care, to be honest. An inside edge and a half century for Ollie Pope. That's pulled away, that's going to be four.
Swept straight through Daryl Mitchell, or reverse swept straight through Daryl Mitchell. There's a roar here from the Western Terrace because Ollie Pope has split those two men that are out on the leg side, and that boundary brings up the 100 partnership between Pope and Root. Oh, we'll get another boundary. He was looking to drive through the covers. It ran off a thick outside edge. There's no third man, as we mentioned. Oh, straight. It's a third consecutive boundary for Ollie Pope, and he gets acknowledgement from Root. Short again. It's going to be 50 to Joe Root, who's played beautifully this evening, and cries of Root. Short, pulled away, it's bad bowling. Start of the over, Bracewell was too full. The last two balls, he's been too short. He just cannot find his length.
Good afternoon, Kumar.
Good afternoon, NASA.
Root has his first run of the day. Oh, gone. Nip back up. New Zealand needed a fast start. They've got one with Southie.
Pope seeing it almost shape away, setting up for the outswinger. Yes, the shine is set for the outswinger, but it's a wobble seam delivery.
That will be the first four of the day, cut by Root.
Oh, up a little bit on the pitch, but Root well in control. That's the beauty of Root, isn't it? He's a traditional test batter.
That could be the same result. You're not catching up when it goes towards that Western Terrace. That's four.
A good over, first up, a wicket, a beautiful delivery, and Bolt really needs to back that up with an over that exerts even more pressure on the England batters. But Joe Root,
well, this is heaven for Yorkshire fans. Free tickets, two Yorkies in the middle, England on a run chase. Bairstow off the mark. I reckon that could run away for four. It does.
They needed pressure from one side, penetration from the other. They've had the wicket from Southie, but this over had really not set the tone that New Zealand wanted this morning.
Yes, yes, yes.
And that is four more.
Bolt just trying to rush through his over, trying to get out of it too quickly, not really focusing or concentrating on what his role is for the first over of the morning. He's just caught up in the moment.
More runs. There's a sweeper out there now.
Well, he has been poor.
Yes. Shot, Johnny Bairstow. Top shot, driven away for four. Bairstow, 14 from five deliveries. A lot wrong with that delivery. Up and over. Has it gone all the way? Yep, it has. He's in a hurry, Johnny Bairstow.
Too hard, it's just a little punch. dragging his fingers across the seam. Saudi trying to make it cut back in, but right in the slot for Bear still. Nice extension, good stride forward. No real flourish.
Could only be one with the slide. Turn to spin pretty soon because there's no rhythm at all here for Trent Bolt.
Definitely not from that end. Could probably go Wagner that end. Change ball to this end to see whether a change of ends will make any difference. Not really sure they can go to spin.
Well, difference in spin has been a massive thing in this game. Whipped off off stump, and he'd have a little smile and maybe a word from Saudi in his ear there, Johnny Bairstow. Gonna have to hurry, they do. Bairstow's quick. Also clipped, there's fine leg. Can he get round? He does, Bolt does well. He's a good athlete, Trent Bolt in the field.
Good afternoon, Michael.
Yeah, this is the way in which Johnny Bairstow is going to take on Michael Bracewell. Did it in the first innings, did it superbly well.
Top edge this time. Good work. Yeah. Really good from Nichols. Maybe have Tuesday off. Practice Wednesday, Thursday, and then back into it again on Friday.
Catch it!
And Bracewell does Johnny Bairstow there, but Bairstow gets away with it. Little glove round the corner. Lifted wide of mid-on. Wagner able to track it down because of the rain we've had. And again, excellent work. Three more to England. Gorgeous. He gave the bowler a little chance there. Stepped a long way across. Had Joe Root missed this, he would have been out for short. Joe Root is missing nothing right now.
But not for Joe Root. Just go, no, he's just getting into position. Works that nicely.
Four more. It's a little wide, it's a little short, and Bairstow helps himself. He moves into the 40s.
Just a mediocre strike rate of 160 for Johnny Bairstow.
Five runs and over. Man went to, into a sort of a gully position, I suppose, a gully that you'd have for a seam bowler. Goes downtown, goes all the way.
Waiting for the right length. He created it with some fantastic footwork again. Yeah, enjoy that.
Yes, that goes, it's one-handed. And the ball goes one bounce to the man out at deep mid-wicket. That's the end of the over. Down the ground, oh, it's imperious, it's dismissive. It's 50 for Bairstow.
Johnny Bairstow's 50.
Oh, he's going to wind up at that as well. He changed his mind. They might come back for two. They do. Tipped away. I don't think Trent Bolt picked that up initially, but there would have been two anyway. Stoke gave himself a bit of room. He gave himself a lot of room early. Bracewell didn't spot it, didn't follow him. That is a terrific cut shot for four.
Bracewell, I think he knows that, sorry, Johnny Pesto, because he knows Bracewell's trying to go wider to try and tempt him out. And even that.
Take four anyway. Tim Southey saw Joe Root looking for the Root scoop again.
Yeah, this is where you go harsh for the keepers, isn't it? Yeah, got the distance, just gone over the top. It's actually
goes for the Yorker. Joe Root pings it away off. Blade. Johnny Bairstow took it by the scruff of the neck. Oh, what a great shot. What a great shot from Joe Root. Such great control. He gets down on that back leg. So he's anchored and balanced. Gets the hands out in front. Head down over the ball. Short, wide, and cut away.
Anything in the series, because he doesn't want to take credit for it at the moment. He knows it's not an overnight turnaround. He knows the players have always had the talent.
I think that's all she wrote. What a way to finish the match. What a way to clinch the series.